Good evening, everybody. I want to welcome you to this first concert of our season, and we're really delighted to see you here. It's a great pleasure to welcome to our stage Dr. Marvin Lamb, who has written for some of this country's leading orchestras, Detroit and Louisville and the National Symphony and many, many others. And we've had the great honor of performing his works through the time that I've been here. We did a wonderful work of his based on Archibald MacLeish's play J.B., called JB2, and then a few years back we played a concerto for this organ called Bop, which I think reflects something of Dr. Lamb's playfulness. And tonight we're going to present this very beautiful work called Sound and Horn. I didn't get together to write program notes here, but I thought to have him here to introduce him to you and to talk about Sound and Horn might be interesting before the show. So first of all, welcome, Dr. Lamb. Thank you for being with us.
Thank you, and it's great to be here and to be in front of this audience and to have this wonderful orchestra play my music. And it's even better that I didn't have to write program notes. So I can just talk my way through it.
Well, you know what, the first thing I wanted to talk to you about was the occasion for this work's writing, and that's connected, I think, to the title of the piece. So
it is indeed. I was asked by a friend of mine of long standing, George Adams, who was then the music director of the Idaho Falls Symphony Orchestra, to write a piece for the Lewis and Clark Bicentenary. And I was delighted to do so because George and his wife Claire have been friends for over 20 years. And I wanted to write something really special for him because he was a good friend and he did give me this wonderful opportunity to make this music. But truth to tell, I didn't know a lot about Lewis and Clark and that travel. My upbringing was in the state of Texas, and American history pretty much stopped with Davy Crockett and the Alamo. And we just kind of stall out there in Texas. So I had to do a lot of background reading, and it was great fun. I learned a ton of stuff, and I had a great experience through it all. And my tour guide through all of this was Byron Price, who is the director of the Charles Russell Center for American Art. And he gave me some very good ideas and steered me to the right books and the right sources. And one of the books that influenced me a great deal was by Larry McMurtry, and it's called Sacagawea's Nickname, which was Janie, by the way. Just spoiler alert there. But in reading that, and in reading Lewis and Clark's journals, which I did, and in talking with Byron a lot, I was impressed by just how tough that journey was, and all of the things that those good folks went through, men and women, in their trek to discover and map and catalog what is now most of the Northwest. I wanted to write something that was reflective of that. I wanted to show their toughness, their mental toughness and their spiritual toughness, but mainly their physical toughness and how they just took this perilous journey. That's the only way to describe it, this perilous journey, never knowing what was around the next bend, in circumstances that could be best described as completely unforgiving. Did you make the wrong move by an inch to the left or the right? And in my study of all of this, I came across this thing called a sounding horn. And I thought, that's it. If that's not the title for a piece, I don't know what is. So a sounding horn. And a sounding horn is basically a bagpipe reed-like instrument that's enclosed in a tin, hammered tin horn that's about that long. And it is designed not as a musical instrument, but it's a way of creating aural orientation. And the job of the boatswain was to stand in the bow of the boat with a sounding horn and peer off into the distance. And he would continually blow this sounding horn when they were lost in the fog or when they didn't know where they were on water or when they were caught in a snowstorm or when all manner of things would happen that would cause them to get caught in the rivers in the dark, not knowing what the next second might bring. And they just used their ears instead of their eyes, which I thought was a wonderful musical metaphor. And they kept hearing this sound that would go, it's an undulating descending minor third. And it's this weird, haunting, bizarre sound that just goes forever when you hear it played on a river. And it was sort of like the bell cow. Everyone would orient to that sound, and as long as the boatswain did his job, no one would perish. And pretty much no one did perish. A very high majority of that crew made it all the way through the journey, particularly given the circumstances. So sound and horn starts with the horns, obviously. And the whole piece is based on that undulating minor third. And it morphs eventually into a march. But the march is not a triumphant march. The march is this sort of slow slog that's cast very low in the string section that is triumphant in nature in a way, but mainly it's a bunch of hard, crusty guys going, thank heavens we made it. You know, we lived, we survived, we can now tell the tale. So sound and horn tells that tale, it spins that song, and I hope you enjoy it very much.
Well, we're looking forward very much to playing it, and on behalf of the orchestra, thank you for such a wonderful piece for us.
Oh, thank you, it's my pleasure entirely. Thank you again.
Good evening. I'm Laurie Millette, director of the School of Music, and I would like to invite everyone, students and audience, to a reception following the performance. It's being hosted by our Friends of Music organization, and we have enough cookies to go around for probably 3 days. So we invite you to come and have some sugar and mingle with our students on stage. Our Friends of Music organization has been in effect for about 6 years now, a wonderful group making donations for student scholarship, of which some of the students on stage have received or are receiving a Friends of Music scholarship. They also provide financial support for student travel and faculty travel. So please join us after the concert, and thank you for being here tonight.